Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. So clearly tell me that whether I am clearly audible to you or not, so that we can quickly start with the session of static GK for your RBI Grade B phase one exam. So quickly tell me whether I am clearly audible to you or not. A very good morning to all of you. Okay, so Shilpa has told me that I am clearly audible, so I am starting with the session. And अभी तो session start भी नहीं हुआ, and Mohit is asking me about the PDF. So Mohit, you don't have to worry about the PDF. This PDF will be provided to all of you guys, irrespective of you being the enrolled student or the unenrolled student. You will be provided with the PDF on our website, and link will be given in the description below. So let's begin the session for today. Last time हमारा session आधा रह गया था because there was some technical issues, but you don't have to worry because I have incorporated those details in this session as well. So the remaining part of that session is provided in this session. Therefore, it might happen that it gets stretched a little. So you have to listen to me very patiently because these topics are really important for your RBI Grade B phase one examination. As I have told you, static GK does hold a major significance in the examination. So let's begin with this session. But before that, those who are coming for the first time, guys, you can subscribe and hit this bell notification so that you don't miss out on the upcoming videos that we are going to upload on our channel. And you can also join this Telegram group where we provide you with the new updates as well as quizzes. And you can also ask your queries on this channel. So if you want to resolve your queries, you can join this Telegram group. Here is our new offering. As I have told you earlier as well, we are offering a 40% discount on our crash course. So if you want to purchase RBI Grade B crash course, you can use this crash 40 coupon code so that you get the 40% discount on the amount. And after this coupon, after this discount, the amount of this course will be around 9,000. So you can buy this course if you want to prepare for the exam this year. Okay. So the first topic that we are going to discuss is the heads of banks in India. So chairman and CEOs of the banks are important, and since these things are the current these things are in the current affairs, so therefore I have created a separate PDF of the bank, Indian Bank's chairman and CEOs, that is provided in the static GK module of our course in detail. And guys, that course is for enrolled students. Okay. So here are the heads of important Indian banks. But before starting that, I'm quickly going out through your chats so that if you have any query, I can answer that. Okay, Rishabh, February current affairs are important. So for the whole month of February, you have to cover the current affairs, and you don't have to worry about it because you will be provided with the sessions of February spotlight. So don't worry about February current affairs. But I hope that you have covered the spotlight till January thoroughly. So do not miss out on that. Cover the current affairs from Spotlight magazine thoroughly. Okay. Now we are going to begin this first topic of our day. And the first topic is these are the banks chairperson and the MD and CEOs. So State Bank of India, Dinesh Kumar Khara is the chairperson, and MDs are four. Therefore, they are not very important for us to remember. But remember this thing that recently two MDs were appointed, and I had taken that question. Okay. Bank of India's chairperson is not there because the highest post in Bank of India is MD and CEO. So Atanu Kumar Das is the MD and CEO of Bank of India. IDBI's chairperson is M.R. Kumar, and Rakesh Sharma is the MD and CEO. Central Bank of India, Tapan Ray and Pallav Mohapatra. Indian Overseas, there is no chairperson, but there is the MD and CEO, Parth Pratim Sen Gupta. Then we have Yes Bank. This bank was in the news. And this person was Sunil Mehta, was appointed in 2020 only. Therefore, it's the current appointment. Sunil Mehta is the chairperson, and Prashant Kumar is the MD and CEO of Yes Bank. Access, we have Rakesh Makhija and Amitabh Chaudhary. HDFC, Deepak Parekh and Shashidhar Jagdishan. This too was a recent appointment in 2020 only. ICICI Bank, Girish Kumar, Girish Chandra Chaturvedi is the chairperson and Sandeep Bakshi is the MD and CEO. Federal Bank, Grace Elizabeth Koshi and Shyam Srinivasan. Guys, the banks that I am highlighting, the highlight is basically due to the new appointment. But that does not mean that you can ignore the other chairpersons and MDs, because all of these are important Indian banks and any question can come on one of these in the examination. So do not miss out on any important appointment or any important designation in the table here. But it's just that you have to pay a little more focus on remembering the current appointments, because they are current. They are in your Spotlight magazine as well. Okay. So Federal Banks, we have discussed. Catholic Syrian Bank, Madhavan Aravamuthan, and the MD and CEO is CVR Rajendran, and the full name of CVR Rajendran is Rajendran Chinna Virappan. Okay, so next is Bank of Maharashtra. There is no chairperson. The MD and CEO is A.S. Rajiv. Punjab and Sindh Bank, since it is in the news, it's important. Charan Singh is the chairperson. S. Krishnan is the MD and CEO. UCO Bank, no chairperson. Atal Kumar Goyal is the MD and CEO. DCB Bank, we have Nasir Munji. This is the chairperson. And Murli N. Natarajan is the MD and CEO. RBL Bank, Prakash Chandra is the chairperson. Vishwaveer Ahuja is the MD and CEO. So these are some of the names that you have to memorize. Okay. DBS Bank, this is again an important bank because it merged with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. So the administration of Lakshmi Vilas Bank has now been shifted to DBS Bank India, which is the Bank of Singapore. Originally, the group belongs to Singapore. Okay. So the chairperson is Lim Sok Hui and the MD and CEO is Surojit Shom. And remember this thing, that these two people head the Indian operation. So Lim Sok Hui is the chairperson of this bank in India and Surojit Shom is the MD and CEO for Indian operations. IDFC First Bank after merger with IDFC and Capital First. So these two merged with IDFC First Bank, or basically we can say these two merged to form this IDFC First Bank. So the MD and CEO is V. Vaidyanathan. This is again an important appointment, guys. Bandhan Bank, Anup Kumar Sinha and Chandrasekhar Ghosh. IndusInd Bank, we have Arun Tiwari and Sumant Katpalia, and this was again an important appointment and a recent one too. Bank of Baroda, Dena Bank and Vijay Bank merged with the BOP. Hence, the managerial control of these two banks transferred to Bank of Baroda. Therefore, the chairperson and the MD and CEO of BOP are responsible for managing the activities of Dena Bank and Vijay Bank. Now, who are these? Hasmukh Adia is the chairperson of Bank of Baroda and Sanjeev Chadha is the MD and CEO. Till now, guys, I hope I'm clear. If you have any doubt, then you can mention it here. Okay. SERI, the syllabus for RBI PO and RBI and SBI PO are not the same. However, it overlaps. Some part of the SBI PO is asked in the RBI exam also. Or I should reframe my sentence as the topics. Some topics are similar in both the examination, but yes, RBI is the overarching examination. Therefore, the syllabus is vast in RBI. So I am assuming that you guys have no problem. Therefore, I am moving ahead with the video. Okay, so here we have the merged banks. And again, I don't think that I need to repeat this thing, how much this merger is important for your examination. So do not forget to cover everything related to the merger of banks. Although it was announced in 2019, but there are chances that it can be asked in this examination also, because this was one of the major step taken by the government of India.
Okay.
So we have PNB, OBC, United Bank of India. So PNB is the anchor bank, is the major bank under which these two are merged. So who is the chairperson of PNB? It's SS Mallikarjun Rao. And who is the MD and CEO? Mr. Rajiv. Canara Bank, again syndicate, is being merged with Canara. So Canara's chairperson is TN Manoharan and MD and CEO is Lingam Venkata Prabhakar. So this appointment was done in 2020. So again, I would say that this was somewhat a recent appointment. Therefore, do not dare to miss it. Revise it properly. Union Bank of India, Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank. So these two banks are being merged with Union Bank of India. Union Bank of India is the anchor bank. Therefore, the MD and CEO that we are going to discuss is of Union Bank of India. So Raj Kiran Rai Ji is the MD and CEO of Union Bank of India. Indian Bank and Allahabad Bank. Allahabad Bank is being merged with Indian Bank and the chairperson is, MD and CEO is Padmaja. Next, Small Finance Bank. So you have AU Small Finance Bank, chairperson Rajvikas Sharma Barma and MD and CEO is Sanjay Agarwal. Suryoday Small Finance Bank, there is no chairperson at present. The MD and CEO is Bhaskar Babu Ramachandran. Ujjivan Small Finance Bank, we have Vishwamohan Mohapatra and Nitin Chugh. Jana Small Finance Bank, Ramesh Ramanathan and Ajay Khanwal. Utkarsh Small Finance Bank, we have only the MD and CEO Govind Singh. So these small finance banks are also very important because they are in the news lately. Therefore, you have to cover the chairperson and MD and CEO of these small finance banks as well. Now we have the payment banks, Airtel Payment Banks. So there are only these six payment banks that operate in India at present. And this thing I have told you earlier as well. So these are the only payment banks that operate in India. So Airtel Payment Bank, Sunil Bharti Mittal, who is also the chairman of Bharati Enterprises, and MD and CEO is Anubhrata Vishwas. India Post Payment Bank, it is PK Bisoi and J. Venkata Ramu, and this was a recent appointment. Guys, do you know that how much equity does Government of India hold in this India Post Payment Bank? If you know, then tell me here. I'm waiting for your answers. Pooja, the PDF will be provided to you. The static GK PDFs are provided already in the static GK module. I'm talking about this PDF, which will be provided to you on our website. And don't worry guys, I will provide you with the link in the description below. Come on, quickly tell me how much equity does Government of India hold in this India Post Payment Bank. Tell me. Okay guys, if you don't know the answer, then mention that only, that you don't know, so that I can proceed with the video further. I can tell you the amount of equity that government hold. Okay, so my students know the answer. Absolutely right. It's 100%, and it's the only payment bank in which the Government of India holds 100% equity. So this is another basic fact that you should be aware of if you are appearing for the RBI Grade B examination. Good. Absolutely right. Fino Payments Bank, Mahendra Kumar Chauhan is the chairperson and Rishi Gupta is the MD and CEO. Then we have Jio Payments Bank. So Jio, this is again the latest payment bank to enter in the list of payment banks. Vivek Bhandari, chairperson, H. Shri Krishnan, MD and CEO. Paytm Payment Bank, Vijay Shekhar Sharma, Satish Kumar Gupta. NSDL Payments Bank, B.A. Prabhakar, G.V. Nageshwara Rao. Guys, I have one question to ask you. Recently, one of the payment bank launched India's first multi-partner FD service. Can you tell me that which payment bank is it? Which payment bank launched India's first multi-partner FD service? Payment bank. Tell me. देखो रे क्रिश एमडी एंड सीईओ के आर इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज एमडी एंड सीईओ इज द सेकेंड मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट डेजिग्नेशन इन अ कंपनी एंड इट कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन. देयरफॉर ओनली दीज टू डेजिग्नेशंस आर देयर फॉर यू टू रिमेंबर. आई नो दैट इफ यू एक्यूमुलेट ऑल द रैंक्स देन इट बिकम्स अ हेक्टिक लॉट बट स्टिल यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द एमडी एंड सीईओस एंड चेयरपर्सन. एब्सोल्युटली राइट. इट्स पेटीएम पेमेंट्स बैंक. So now we are done with the bank's headquarter, sorry, banking chairpersons and the CEOs. Now we are on the heads of regulators in India. So this, I don't think that I have to reiterate the importance of this topic. So do listen to me very carefully. Regulators, first is our RBI, Shaktikant Das, headquarters is Mumbai. SEBI, Ajay Tyagi, headquarters Mumbai. IRDAI, Subhash Chandra Kuntia. Headquarters Hyderabad. Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority Supratim Bandyopadhyay, New Delhi headquarters. And this was the recent appointment in the year 2020. This person was appointed. TRAI, that is Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. The chairperson is P.D. Baghela, New Delhi. Again a new appointment, a current appointment I would say. NABARD G.R. Chintala, that is Govind Rajulu Chintala. And headquarters is in Mumbai. Okay. Next we have judicial heads. And who comes under the judicial head? First is our Chief Justice of India, which is Sharad Arvind Bobade. Attorney General of India is K.K. Venugopal. Solicitor General of India is Tushar Mehta. So these two people are important. And NGT ka chairperson is Adarsh Kumar Goyal, Justice Adarsh Kumar Goyal. Nothing much for us to discuss. Okay. Constitutional heads. So who comes under this head? We have the first Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, Controller and Auditor General of India, that is Girish Chandra Murmu. Chairperson of 14th Finance Commission was Y.V. Reddy, and the 15th Finance Commission chairperson is Nand Kishore Singh, and 16th has not been formed yet. So we have the latest one till 15th Finance Commission, and now I would like to alert you guys that 15th Finance Commission had submitted its report, its findings. So do listen to the do read that report for your examination. Okay. Okay, next is heads of armed forces. Chief of Defence Staff is Bipin Rawat. Army Force Chief is Air Force Chief is Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria. Navy Chief is Karambir Singh and Army Chief is Manoj Mukund Naravane. So these are the latest appointments or the latest position holders. Next we are on the international organizations. So let's see what we have in this topic. So we have the organization establishment here, headquarters, members and president chief of major international organizations. So I have arranged these organizations on the basis of the place. So how many organizations have headquarters in Geneva? These have been summed together in this table. So let's look at the organizations. So first is World Trade Organization, which was established in the year 1995, Geneva, Switzerland, and the current number of members that World Trade Organization has is 164. And the chief, Roberto was the chief, but he has stepped down from the position, and right now the appointment procedure is in the process. So there is no chief at present of WTO. International Labour Organization, 1919. Geneva, Switzerland, 187 is the number of current members, and Guy Ryder is the chief. Now I would like to ask you a question. There was a person from India who was appointed as the head of the governing body of ILO. Tell me the name of that person. Very recent appointment. Tell me the name. Okay. Come on. Okay, so Ray Krish is mentioning PD Wagela is succeeding RS Sharma. Absolutely right, Krish. Sandeep Agarwal, why? It's Apoorva Chandra. Ishita has mentioned it rightly. It's Apoorva Chandra who has been appointed as the chief of the governing body of ILO. That's the major important fact that you should be aware of. Okay, World Health Organization, 1948 is the year of establishment. Geneva is in Switzerland is the headquarters. 194 is the number of members. Remember, this is after joining of USA. And Tedros Adhanom is the chief of this organization. Guys, can you tell me that on which date was World Health Organization established? Because on this day, we observe the World Health Day. So tell me the date. Basically, World Health Day is celebrated only to commemorate the establishment of World Health Organization. So tell me the date on which World Health Day is observed. Absolutely right. It's 7th April. Next, International Telecommunication Union, 1865 is the year of establishment. Geneva, Switzerland is the headquarters, 193 members, and Holin Zhao is the new is the chief of this organization, International Telecommunication Union. So if for your examination you cover this table only, then I think that international organization question, you will be easily able to answer question if there is a question from this segment, international organization. Okay. Then we have World Meteorological Organization, 1950, Geneva, Switzerland, 187 member states, and this person is the chief, Petri Talas. World Intellectual Property Organization, 1967 is the year of establishment, Geneva, Switzerland, 193, Darren Tang. So these facts are important. So do remember the whole table, especially the number of members, the chief, and the headquarters, of course, and the year of establishment. So all the things mentioned here, you have to remember. So now we are not following that pattern of city-wise, because you can see that there is hardly any similarity in the cities. So first we have the United Nations Industrial Development Organization, which was established in 1966. Vienna, Austria is the headquarters. 170 number of countries are members of this organization, and Li Yong is the present chief of this organization. World Tourism Organization, 1975, Madrid, Spain is the headquarters of WTO. 159 countries, and Zurich is the head. International Maritime Organization, 1948, London is the headquarters, Maritime Organization. Remember, 174 are the member states and 3 are associate members. So this is something that you should be aware of. Only 3 are there, which are the associate members of this organization. And this person is the chief, Kitak Lim. Universal Postal Union, 1874. Bern, Switzerland, 192 members, and Vishal is the chief. International Monetary Fund, IMF, is an important organization. 1945, Washington, D.C., 190. So, last joining was Andorra, and this was in the year 2020 only. So, this country joined IMF and became the 190th member of IMF only in 2020. Therefore, it's an important question from your current affairs point of view as well. Kristalina Georgieva is the chief. Okay. So here I would like to ask you a question. Guys, can you tell me through which treaty or through which conference was IMF established? Because IMF and World Bank are called dash twins. So tell me the name of the conference through which these two organizations established. बहुत ही बढ़िया. इट्स ब्रिटन वुड्स ट्विंस दैट वर्ल्ड बैंक एंड IMF आर कॉल्ड एंड इट्स द ब्रिटन वुड्स कॉन्फ्रेंस दैट एस्टैब्लिश्ड द IMF एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक. एब्सोल्युटली राइट गाइस. यूनेस्को 1945 एस्टैब्लिशमेंट. पेरिस फ्रांस इज द हेडक्वार्टर्स. 193 इज द नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स एंड ऑड्रे इज द प्रेजेंट चीफ. इंटरनेशनल सिविल एविएशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन 1944. मॉन्ट्रियल कैनेडा is the headquarters. Now 193 number of members and Fang Liu is the present chief. Next, International Fund for Agricultural Development 1977, Rome, Italy. 177 are the members and Gilbert Hombu is the present chief. Food and Agricultural Organization 1945, Rome, Italy. Again, these two organizations share the same headquarters, but do not confuse them or do not merge them because it will create confusion in the examination. Okay, Food and Agricultural Organization 1945, Rome, Italy. 194 members hai. And Qiu Dongyu, who belongs to China, is the president. United Nations 1945, New York. 193 member states hai, 2 observer states hai, and which 2 are the observer states? It's Holy See and State of Palestine. This is something that you should remember, that these 2 countries are the observers of United Nations, and Antonio Guterres is the Chief Secretary General. Next comes World Bank. So World Bank was established in 1945-44. Bretton Woods twins, and we have Washington DC US as its headquarter. Members, so it is made up of 5 organizations as you can see in this smart art, so we will be discussing that, but let's discuss the president of World Bank, that is David Malpass. Now we have the World Bank and the 5 arms of World Bank. The first one is International Bank of Reconstruction and Development, IBRD. It was established in 1944 and the current number of members is 189. International Development Association 1960, 173 members. International Financial Corporation 1956, 185 members. Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency 1988, 182 members. International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes 1966, 155 members. Now guys, the point that you should pay attention to is that all these 5 organizations are located in the Washington DC. So Washington DC is the common headquarters of all these 5 arms of World Bank. So that's all here. The international organization headquarters and everything important related to them ends. If you have any query, then you can ask me here. Okay, so I presume that you don't have any query, therefore I'm moving ahead with the video. The next topic is regional organizations. So first organization that we have is SAARC, South Asian Association of for regional cooperation. First is 1985. Establishment year is 1985. Headquarters is Kathmandu, Nepal, and member states are 8. Asia. Then we have 1967 is the establishment year. Jakarta, Indonesia is the headquarters. So you guys are not mentioning any query. So I'm moving ahead. Okay, and 10 Southeast Asian countries are the members of this ASEAN group. Guys, recently ASEAN has been in the news for its RCEP initiative, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. Can you tell me that how many countries have signed this RCEP? So this is one of the very hot topic and it has been in the news for years now. Tell me how many countries have signed it actually. It's 15. And which country has dropped out from this partnership? It's India. So India was supposed to be the 16th member to sign this, but it withdrew from this partnership, and now only 15 countries are part of this ARC. Okay. European Union was established in 1993, Brussels, Belgium, and 27 countries are members. Earlier 28, but Britain exited this organization. Shanghai Cooperation Group, 2001 establishment. Beijing, China is the headquarters. Though the name is Shanghai, but the headquarters is Beijing. Remember, 8 countries are members of this, and the latest to join this organization are India and Pakistan. Asia Pacific Cooperation, Economic Cooperation, APEC, 1989, Singapore is the headquarter, 21 countries are the members. Forum for India Pacific Island Cooperation, 2014, only two summits of this forum has been held. First was in Fiji and second was in Jaipur, and that's all. The forum has become, I would say, has become dormant now because there is no summit or there is no news or no activity coming from this forum. But this is just presumption, not an actual statement from any of the government. So don't presume it that this forum has become dormant. It's just my statement. Okay. So 2014, two summits, and India and 14 Pacific Island nations are members of this forum. Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, 1961 establishment, Paris, France, 37 active members. Okay. Next we have G7, the group of seven, the seven developed countries. 1975 is the year of establishment, and seven countries are the members. Then we have G20, 1999 is the year of establishment. Headquarters nahi hai, 20 members. Now I will tell you that why the headquarters of G7 and G20 are not mentioned here. The reason behind this is that G20 and G7 do not have their permanent headquarters. They operate through summits, and the summits are the responsibility of the host country. Therefore, you have to remember that there is no headquarter for G7 and G20. G77, established in 1964, New York is the headquarters. Basically, at the UN headquarters, this grouping of G77 operates. 134 are the members, and remember the G77, group of 77. The name has been retained because earlier the foundation countries were 77. Now the total number of members has increased to 134. So this is something that can confuse you in the exam. Therefore, pay attention to this. BRICS, 2006, NDB, 2006 is the year of establishment. NDB is the New Development Bank that was established by BRICS, and it is headquartered in Shanghai, China, and members are 5. World Economic Forum, 1971 is the year of establishment. Geneva, Switzerland is the headquarters. And why the members are not mentioned here? Because World Economic Forum has over 300 member organizations, not countries. Therefore, that's not important for us to remember. The Australia Group, 1985, Australia is the headquarters, 43 are the members. Next, we have Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. So this is an important organization. 2016 is the year of establishment, Beijing, China, headquarters, and 103 are the member countries. ADB, again an important organization. 1966, Manila, Philippines, and 68 member countries. Majority of these are from Asia Pacific region. European Bank for Reconstruction and Development, 1991, London, UK, and 69 countries and two European Union institutions. OPEC, Organization for Petroleum Exporting Countries. We have 1960 year of establishment. Vienna, Austria is the headquarters, and 13 countries are the member of this title, or we can say this international organization. So we are done with the regional organizations as well. Now we are on our next topic, stock market and their indices. So this is nothing but the stock exchanges that are mentioned here and their indices that they operate. So Bombay Stock Exchange has Sensex and it is the oldest stock exchange in Asia, located at Dalal Street, Mumbai. National Stock Exchange, largest stock exchange in India by market capitalization. It operates Nifty 50, a listing of 50 companies. New York Stock Exchange, nickname is the Big Board. So this is something that a question can be made upon, that which stock exchange is known as the Big Board. So it's New York Stock Exchange. It's the world's largest stock exchange by market capitalization and world's first stock exchange. So you have these are the indices that New York Stock Exchange operate. Okay, then we have National Association of Securities Dealers Automated Quotations, that is NASDAQ, the first electronic stock market in the world, which is in New York, and it operates NASD 100 indices. Tokyo Stock Exchange, which is in Japan, Nikkei 225. Korea Stock Exchange, KOSPI is the name of the index. Shanghai Corporation Stock Exchange. We have Composite Index, then Shenzhen Stock Exchange, again in China, Composite Index is there. Hong Kong Stock Exchange, Hang Seng is the name of the exchange. Singapore Stock Exchange, Straits Time Index. Then we have Frankfurt Stock Exchange, which belongs to Germany. It has DAX. London Stock Exchange, FTSE 100. Then we have France Stock Exchange, CAC 40. These were some of the static things that you have to remember. Countries, capitals, and currency. So this is the table that I have provided to you guys. You can read them on their own. I'm not going to cover this thing here. This is very simple and needs no explanation. Here are the countries, here are the capitals, and here are the currencies. But it's just that if you locate them on the map and memorize them through that, then it will be easier for you to remember. So these are the countries, capitals, and their currencies. I have mentioned it here in the table. Let's look at the notes that we have here. The first note is Indonesia is planning to move its capital city from Jakarta to Kalimantan, which is yet to be built. So remember this thing that at present the headquarters, the capital is Jakarta only, and it has not been shifted, but it is being planned to be shifted. Hong Kong is the special administrative region of China, and eight West African countries that are these, they have changed their currency from CFA franc to ECO. So this is something that you should be aware of, and this was the latest update in 2019. This was done in 2019. So that's all for this topic. Parliaments of different countries. This is something that we can discuss. We have India. India's is Sansad. Pakistan's is National Assembly. Britain's is Parliament, House of Commons, and House of Lords. Germany is Bundestag. Bundestag. So this is something that you should be aware of. Okay, Switzerland's Federal Assembly. Then we have USA Congress, House of Representatives, and Senate are the two divisions. Norway's Storting is the name of the Parliament. Spain, Courts Generals. Australia is Federal Parliament. Denmark is Folketing, and Russia's is Duma and Federal Council. So these are the names of the parliaments of these countries, and remember that these countries are important countries. China, National People's Congress. France, National Assembly. Bhutan's Shogun. So this is a very unique name. Bangladesh, Jatiya Sansad. Myanmar, Pewtu, and what's this? Luthong. Then we have Nepal, Rashtriya Panchayat. Iran's Majlis. Afghanistan, Shura, and Maldives, People's Majlis. Then we have Japan, Diet is the name of the Parliament of Japan. Israel is Knesset. Guys, recently India and Afghanistan have signed an agreement to build a dam. Can you name that dam? Which dam is it that India is going to build in Afghanistan? And for that, an agreement has been signed very recently. Tell me the name of that dam. Ayushi, some of these countries are in news, but in general, the countries comprise of the whole important countries that India deals with, or the countries that are of importance in the global scale. Therefore, I have mentioned all the countries. So if this is your static GK session, therefore you should be aware of all the countries and their currencies and capitals. So this was the static GK, static portion. Shatut, absolutely right, Ashish. Next comes the major hydropower projects in India. So guys, do listen to me very carefully in this topic, because this topic not only has the hydroelectric powers which are already there in India, it also includes the projects that India plans to build. So therefore, this topic is very important. Do listen to me very carefully. So we have the first state, that is Jammu and Kashmir, which is not a state now, it's the Union Territory. Okay. So Uri is the first dam that we have, and it is on Jhelum River. So here the name of the dams and here the rivers and the state are mentioned. So all these three facts related to a dam are very important. So Uri, Dalhasti and Salal, Lower Kalnai, Pakaldul, all these are established dams. Datle is under construction. Hirthai, Sawalkot. Then we have these two are mentioned above only. So these three are under construction. So these three are the planned, or we can say are under development. These three hydroelectric power projects in Jammu and Kashmir, and the rivers of them are Chenab. So all these three are being built on Chenab River. This is something that you should remember, because these are in the news only. Next, Shamera 1. So we are on Himachal Pradesh. Shamera 1 and 2, Pongis Dam. Okay, so the rivers Shamera 1 and 2 are on Ravi River. Pongis Dam is on Bees River. So the name Bees Dam is is derived from the river only. Baspa 2 River is on Baspa, which is a tributary of Satluj River. So this is again an important fact. Nathpa Jhakri Dam is on Satluj River. This dam is important. Then we have Karcham Vantu Dam, which is again on Satluj River. Dehar Dam is on Geez River. Luhuri Stage 1 Hydroelectric Power Project. So this is again the under construction power project which was in the news. Therefore, it's important. Himachal Pradesh, and the river is Satluj. Bhagada Nangal Dam is in Himachal Pradesh and Punjab. The river is Satluj. Tihri Dam is in Uttarakhand. River is Bhagirathi. Sardar Sarovar is in Gujarat, Narmada. Teesta, Sikkim, river is Teesta. Ranjit 4 hydropower project. So again, the word project is mentioned here because it is still in the development stage. It is Sikkim, and the river is named as Ranjit. Damodar Valley project, West Bengal and Jharkhand, the river is Damodar. Hirakud, Odisha, Mahanadi is the river, and Bellimala is again in Odisha, and the river is Siler. Subhansri hydropower project. This is again under development project. Arunachal Pradesh, the river is Subhansri. Italian hydroelectric project. It is in Arunachal Pradesh, Dibang River. It is again the under construction project. Next, Koyna. Koyna Dam is in Maharashtra, Koyna River. Loktak hydroelectric project. So this is something unique because it is on the Loktak Lake, not a river. Indra Sagar, Madhya Pradesh, Narmada. Omkareshwar, Madhya Pradesh, Narmada. This is again an important dam. Omkareshwar, it was in the news. Shravati, Karnataka. Shravati is the name of the river. Kalinadi, it's again Kalinadi River, Karnataka. Idukki, Kerala, Periyar River. Tungabhadra is an important dam. And this one also. So Andhra Pradesh, Tungbhadra, which is a river, a tributary of Krishna River. Sri Salam Dam, Krishna River. Nagarjuna Sagar, again Krishna River, and the state is same, Andhra Pradesh. Kopili Hydroelectric Power Project, this is again in the news, this was important. Assam, and the river is Kopili. So we are done with the hydroelectric power projects. Guys, do pay attention to the hydroelectric power projects that are in news, that are under construction. Now we are on our major thermal power projects in India. Okay, so the first is Mundra Thermal Power Project, which is in Gujarat. Then we have Sitka, which is again in Gujarat. So all these are in Gujarat. Banagbori Thermal Power Project, Jhanaur Gandhar TPS, Kawas TPS and Ukai TPS. All these thermal power plants are in Gujarat. Then we have Rihand Thermal Power Project in Sonbhadra, Uttar Pradesh. Rihand Anpara, Obra, Singrauli, Super. So these are the different names of thermal power project, thermal power stations. And this is in Sonbhadra, Uttar Pradesh. Ghatampur TPS, Tanda TPS, all these two are again in Uttar Pradesh. And remember that this is this belongs to NTPS, National Thermal Power Corporation. Vindhyanchal, it is in Madhya Pradesh. Satpura, Madhya Pradesh. Sanjay Gandhi Thermal Power Station, this is important. Sanjay Gandhi Thermal Power Station is in Madhya Pradesh. Amarkantak, Madhya Pradesh. Talcher is in Odisha. Okay, so Tapovan Dam washed off in UK. Very good, guys. Very good, Akhil. If this is in the news, then you should be aware of Tapovan Dam. Absolutely right. Jharsuguda TPS is again in Odisha. Korba, Sipat, Bhilai, Shyamaprasad Mukherjee. So these are the names of thermal power stations in Chhattisgarh, out of which this Shyamaprasad Mukherjee thermal power station is the most important. Bellary TPS, Udupi TPS, Udgi Super TPS are these three are in Karnataka. Okay, then we have the TPS belonging to West Bengal. Durgapur, Bandel, Kolaghat and Faraka. Faraka was in the news. Faraka is important. Bakreshwar, Sagardighi and Santaldi. So these are in West Bengal. These TPS are in West Bengal. Then we have Amravati, Chandrapura Super, Super Guswal and Trombay, Koradi, Thaper Kheda, Paras and Tiroda. All these thermal power stations are in Maharashtra. Tamil Nadu mein ye hain, Method, Innor and Neyveli. Jharkhand ke hain Bokaro, Methon, Jojobera and Patratu. Andhra Pradesh ke hain Simhadri, Nagla Data, Rao TPS, Badauni TPS and Kahalgaon TPS are in Bihar. So these two are in Bihar and these two are in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so this is the last lot of thermal power stations. Andhra thermal power station is Rajasthan, Barsingsar in again in Rajasthan, Suratgarh and Giral Lignite TPS is again in Rajasthan. So there was no new addition to the thermal power station, no new project is being built in the thermal power station sector. Therefore, no need to pay much attention, but yes, you should remember the static GK existing thermal power stations which are there in India and all those that I have mentioned here. And if you have paid attention to the slides, then you should see this thing that I have categorized the thermal power stations on the basis of states. So if you remember them through that, then it will be easier for you to memorize them and retain them. Now let's move on to the nuclear power plants in India, and I suppose there is again no new addition in this sector, no new nuclear power plant or atomic power plant is being built in India at present. So we have Naroda Atomic Power Plant in Naroda, Uttar Pradesh. Rajasthan Atomic Power Plant in Rajasthan. Tarapur is in Maharashtra. Jaipur is in Ratnagiri, Maharashtra. Kakrapar, Gujarat. Guys, this was in the news. Because of some technical or operational error that it faced, it was very much in the news. Kakrapar Atomic Power Plant, which is in Gujarat. Remember this thing. Madras is Tamil Nadu, very easy to remember. Kaika Atomic Power Plant is in Karnataka. Kudankulam is in Tamil Nadu. Kalapakkam is in, again, Tamil Nadu. So we are done with the power plants now, and we are on the heads that are there in India. So let's see. Okay, so we have discussed the heads, that is judicial heads, constitutional heads, heads of armed forces, heads of regulators in India. Okay, so we have discussed it. Now we are on important passes in the Himalayas, which are there in the different states in Himalayas. So these are the names of the passes. These are the connections from which state or from which side of India, which country is being connected through which pass. So this is something that is very basic for you to know. So we have at first Mintaka, which is between China and Kashmir. Then Parbat, China and Kashmir again. Khunjerab, China and Kashmir. So these are the passes that join Kashmir with China. Adhil Pass is again China and Kashmir. Benihal Pass is Jammu and Kashmir. Changla is Ladakh and Tibet. Debsa Pass is Himachal Pradesh. Mansa Dura Pass is Uttarakhand. Pitorgarh and Mulingla Pass is in Uttarakhand. Khardungla is in Ladakh range and it is world's highest motorable pass. So this is the speciality of this Khardungla Pass, which is very important. Zozila, Srinagar, Kargil, and the Zozila Tunnel that is being built, which is the longest tunnel in India and in Asia as it's supposed to be. Tell me the length of this Zozila Tunnel, because it is claimed to be the largest, the longest tunnel in Asia and India. So tell me the length of this tunnel, Zozila Tunnel. Of course, Shivangi, you will be provided with the PDF of both the sessions, static GK part 1 as well as this one. Absolutely right, Shilpa, it's 14.2 kilometers. Good. Okay. Thank you, Dipanshu, for recognizing it. And do not worry, I will be providing you with the PDF of this session as well so that you can memorize it or revise it later. The example. Absolutely right, Shilpa. It's longest bi-directional tunnel. So this is something that I would like to hear from you, and I heard it from you. Absolutely right, Shilpa. It's the longest bi-directional tunnel. 14.2 kilometers. Good. Okay, so let's come back to the passes again. We have Barala Chapla, which is in Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir. Shipkila, Himachal and Tibet. Rohtang Pass, the next Kullu, Lahore and Spiti, near Manali. Then we have Niti Pass, Uttarakhand and Tibet. Lipu Lake Pass, Uttarakhand and Tibet and Nepal. Nathula, Sikkim and Tibet. Chalepla, Sikkim and Tibet, and it passes through Chumbi Valley. Bondi Dala, Arunachal Pradesh and Bhutan. Dihang Pass, Arunachal Pradesh and Myanmar. This is important. Dihang Pass is important. Yongyap Pass, Arunachal Pradesh and Tibet. Difar Pass is India, China, Myanmar. Then we have Mana Pass, also known as Manala or Chebitya or Dumrila. So these three are the name of this Mana Pass only. Uttarakhand and Tibet. It is located inside the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve, which is in Uttarakhand. This is an important part of this Manna Pass. Karatak Pass, it is in Jammu and Kashmir. So the next topic is important peaks in the Himalaya. So these are the important peaks. Mount Everest hai, Godwin Austin hai, Kanchenjunga, Lhotse and Meshadram and Kanchenjunga is again written here. It is the Indian side, Kanchenjunga, and it is the Indo-Nepal border. Then we have Nanga Parbat. These are some important peaks in Himalayas. Next is awards and honors. So, in this topic, we will be discussing the different awards which are given in different fields. Now, you should be aware of this thing that which award is given in which field. So, let's have a look at the awards and honors. Nobel Prize. It is given in peace, literature, medicine, physics, chemistry and economics. So, these are the six fields in which Nobel Prize is given. So, this is so very basic. I hope that every student who is preparing for competitive exam should be aware of this fact that Nobel is given in six categories, and the name of all these six categories as well as the winners are very important. PDF will be given to you through the website and I will provide you with the link. Okay, Suhani, you are asking me about morning tales. Okay, so since I am taking these sessions, therefore morning tales is not provided for these days, but I will be providing you with the morning tales for tomorrow. So you have to keep that patience. If you want me to do the sessions for you, then you have to have the patience. Okay, then we have the next prize, Pulitzer Prize, which is in journalism, letter and music. So journalism writing, letter writing and in the field of music, Pulitzer. Oscars. Oscars are also known as Academy Awards. So films ki field mein diya jata hai. Kalinga Award is given in the field of science. Booker Prize, literature, Grammy, music. Ramon Magsaysay Award, public service, social service, journalism, literature, communication and international understanding. This is an important award, Bharat Ratna, any field of human endeavor, and this is the highest civilian order of honor of India. Dada Saheb Phalke Award, films ki field mein diya jata hai. Gyanpith Award is given in the field of literature. Saraswati Samman, again literature. Vyas Samman is again literature. Dronacharya Award, sports, coaching mein diya jata hai, and this is the highest honor in the field of sports. So highest civilian sports award given by India, Dronacharya Award. Then we have Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award as well. So Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, then Dronacharya Award, then we have Arjun Award. Arjun Award is again in the field of sports. Dhanvantri Award in the field of medical science, homeopathy particularly. Ramanujan Award in the field of mathematics. Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad Trophy, also known as Makka Trophy. So this is the abbreviated form of this Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad Trophy. So this is given by President to universities in India for promoting sports. Tenzing Norgay National Adventure Sports Award. So again, this is the highest honor for adventure sports in India. So these are the awards. Joint Military Exercises of India. So I hope that this is the topic of your interest and you will listen to me very carefully and with interest as well. So let's begin this topic, which has the joint military exercises that India conducts with other countries. So first section under the joint military exercises is of army exercise. So India and Japan, Dharma Guardian, India and Uzbekistan, it's Dasnik, and it was the in the year 2019 only. So this started in the year 2019 only. Absolutely. Yeah. Uzbekistan, oh yeah. USA, including Tri Services, Tiger Triumph. So Tiger Triumph is the exercise with USA that includes all the three services, Navy, Army and Air Force. Singapore, Board Kurukshetra, Australia, Austria, Hind, Bangladesh, Sampriti, China, Hand in Hand, France, Shakti. Guys, whenever you are covering the military exercises, you should pay attention to the kind of exercise that it is, whether it is an army exercise, whether it is an air force exercise or a naval exercise, because this is something which comprises your basic understanding. So that should be clear in your head that which exercises which. If you are asked about Sampriti, then you should be aware about this thing that Sampriti is the army exercise that India conducts with Bangladesh. France exercise Shakti, Indonesia Garuda Shakti. So this is a little confusing for you, so do pay attention when you are remembering these two exercises. France and Indonesia, Shakti, Shakti is common. Kazakhstan, Prabal, Dosti and Kazin. So Kazin is Kazakhstan and India. So this one is easy to remember and this requires a little effort from your side. Kyrgyzstan, Khanjar. Maldives is Equivalent. Mongolia is Nomadic Elephant. So this is an important exercise. I guess there was a question on Nomadic Elephant. So with which country does India conduct this Nomadic Elephant exercise? It's with Mongolia. So we are continuing with the Indian Army exercises. With Nepal, India conducts Surya Kiran. So exercises are the most important part of your strategy kit as well as your current affairs portion. Oman, with Oman Al Naga. So this is the name. Russia, Indra is the name. Seychelles, Lamitai. Sri Lanka, Mitra Shakti. Thailand, Maitri. UK, Ajay Warrior. USA, Yudh Abhyas. So recently, very recently in the year 2021, 16th edition of Yudh Abhyas was held by India and USA. Vajra Prahar is another exercise conducted by USA. Vietnam, Winbax and X-Force 18. So this is the multinational exercise done by this grouping, ADMM+. So this is the Asian Defense Grouping and this was conducted by all the Asian members, Exercise Force 18, including India. Malaysia ke saath India does Harimau Shakti. So the first edition of this exercise was run in 2018 only. Indian naval exercises with other countries. Bangladesh ke saath it's INBIN. INBN, that is India and Bangladesh Naval Exercise, and Bongo Sagar. So the second edition of this Bongo Sagar was held in 2020 only. So this one is important. Bongo Sagar, India and Bangladesh. Myanmar, IMNEX 19. Malaysia, Samudra Lakshmana. So this is the year in which this exercise was conducted, 2019. Samudra Lakshmana with Malaysia. Singapore, India, Thailand, SITMAX. So SITMAX and SIMBEX were recently conducted in the later half of 2020. So remember this. Vietnam, NVPN bilateral exercise. Australia, OS Index. So guys, do you remember which country has proposed to join this OS Index exercise? This one I have covered. If you remember, then mention it. Which country is proposing to join this OS Index exercise between India and Australia? Okay, I'm waiting for some more answers. Shilpa and Ishita have given their answers. But what about others? Shivansh is also mentioning France. Ishita is saying France. Shilpa is saying USA. What about you all guys? Absolutely right. It's France. France has shown the interest to join this OS Index exercise. Bangladesh, with Bangladesh, it's INBN Corpet. नेवल एक्सरसाइज, ब्राजील एंड साउथ अफ्रीका, तो IBSAMAR द नेम ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज, फ्रांस के साथ बरो नेवल एक्सरसाइज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, इंडोनेशिया इट्स इंडो कॉर्पेट एंड इंडो इंडो माइलेट एंड ऑल्सो समुद्र शक्ति, मलेशिया इनमिन टेबल टॉप एक्सरसाइज. नेक्स्ट म्यांमार इमकॉड एंड INMM बायलेट, ओमान के साथ नसीम अल बहार, सो दिस इज द एक्सरसाइज विच इंडिया कंडक्ट्स विद ओमान. रशिया इंद्र नेवी, सो इंद्र इज द नेम ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज. श्रीलंका सिनेक्स विद सिंगापुर इट्स सिम्पेक्स, विद थाईलैंड इट्स इंडिया थाई कॉर्पेट एक्सरसाइज. सो कॉर्पेट इज कोऑर्डिनेटेड पेट्रोलिंग एक्सरसाइज that India does with other countries as well, not just with Thailand. So India has conducted this corpet exercise with Indonesia as well and other countries also. UAE, INUAE bilateral. Then we have UK, Konkan is the name. USA, Japan trilateral exercise Malabar, and in the 2020 edition, Australia also joined this exercise Malabar. With USA, we have JIMPAC exercise. Okay, multilateral exercise with Brunei. So it's ADMM plus exercise. Name is ADMM plus exercise. Multilateral exercise by Indonesia. The name is Komodo. Japan, with Japan, we conduct bilateral maritime exercise, which is named as JIMAX. Japan's With Japan's Coast Guard, Indian Coast Guard holds this Sahyog Kaijin. Sahyog Kaijin is the exercise between the Coast Guards of India and Japan. This is something that you should be aware of, Coast Guard, not Navy. So Coast Guard is the branch that operates on the line of Indian Navy, but is not the exactly Indian Navy. So Coast Guard and Japan's Coast Guard conducts this Sahyog Kaijin. Next is the Indian Force exercises. So with Japan, Shinyu Maitri is the name. Oman, exercise Eastern Bridge 5th. USA, Cope India. France is at Garud. Bangladesh, tabletop exercise. With Israel, Blue Flag is the name. Oman is at Eastern Bridge. Then Russia is at 5th. Then we have Singapore. It's just the joint military trainings that were done with Thailand, Siam Bharat, with UAE, Desert Eagle is the name of the exercise. With UK, Indradhanush, USA, Red Flag. Multinational air exercise. Exercise Samvedana with Bangladesh, Nepal, Sri Lanka and UAE. So India conducted this Air Force exercise named Samvedana with Bangladesh, Nepal, Sri Lanka and UAE. Therefore, it's a multinational air exercise. Some important exercise that India conducts on its own. So, in these exercises, Indian Navy, Army, Coast Guard or Air Force participate. So, this is something that India conducts on its own. Himvijay, Indian Army exercise. Sudarshan Chakra Vahini, again Indian Army. Milan is Indian Navy's exercise. Then we have Kharga Prahar, Indian Army and Indian Air Force. Bull Strike, Indian Army, Navy and Air Force. Sea Vigil, Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard. Throwbacks, the theater level readiness and operational exercise, Indian Army, Air Force, Navy and the Coast Guard. Exercise Kavach. So this was done by the tri-services under the Andaman and Nicobar command. MFEX, tri-services, joint amphibious exercise. So this MFEX includes all the three forces of Indian Army. Sagar Kavach, Indian Navy and Coast Guard along with the coastal state government. So this is basically a vigilance exercise that Indian Navy and Coast Guard do along the coast of India. Then we have again Bull Strike I have told you. Suraksha Kavach. This is done by Indian Army and Maharashtra Police. So this was the exercise that was done only by Indian Army and Maharashtra Police, and no other edition of this exercise has been done lately. Then we have this SARES, Search and Rescue Exercise, Indian Coast Guard does that exercise. Some international military exercises conducted for the first time in 2020 to 2021. This table is very important for you to remember. First is with France Air Force, Desert Night 21, and what is the location? Jodhpur Air Force Station, India. So this is very recent. This was done in the later half of 2020. Again with France, we have a new exercise. This is Skyros, and this is a war game exercise, Jodhpur, Rajasthan. This UNESCO's Intergovernmental Oceanographic Commission naval exercise named as IO Wave 20. Although it was not the first edition in 2020, but still it's a very important exercise. Okay guys, so this is the last topic, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and biosphere reserves, that we are going to cover in this video. Okay, I hope that it is visible clearly to you. So the first state of which we will be discussing the national parks, biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries and any other speciality related to the environment is Andhra Pradesh. So the first thing that we will be encountering is wildlife sanctuary. Gundla Bhamreshwar Wildlife Sanctuary, Kondinya Wildlife Sanctuary, which is popular for elephant reserves. Only sanctuary in Andhra Pradesh with Asian elephants. Nagarjun Sagar Sri Selam Wildlife Sanctuary, Tiger Reserve. It's famous for being a tiger reserve, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Pulikat Lake Wildlife Sanctuary, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. Why are two states mentioned here? The reason behind this is that the wildlife sanctuaries are not circumscribed to one state only. They can expand to other states as well, because it's the natural geographical area that is being conserved. Therefore, we cannot create boundaries between the wildlife sanctuaries. Therefore, two states are mentioned here. Krishna Wildlife Sanctuary, it is considered as one of the rarest eco-regions in the world due to its mangrove forest. So, this is in Andhra Pradesh. Then we have Sri Lanka Maleshwara Wildlife Sanctuary, only habitat in the world which provides home for the Jerdon's courser, a highly endangered bird species. So guys, in this block you can see the speciality of the wildlife sanctuaries or national parks are mentioned. This is something that you should be covering and do not ignore them. Okay, so let me zoom in. Now is it clear? I hope now is it visible to you guys. Okay, I hope that it is clearly visible to you. So I'm moving ahead. If there is any problem, then you can mention here. Okay. So let's begin. So Sri Lanka Maleshwara Wildlife Sanctuary we have discussed. Then we have Sri Penisula Narasimha Wildlife Sanctuary, again in the Andhra Pradesh, in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Now we have national parks. Sri Venkateshwara National Park, Yellow-Throated Bulbul, Oriental White-backed Vulture, which is critically endangered. These two are the specialities of this Sri Venkateshwara National Park, which is again in Andhra Pradesh. It is also a biosphere reserve. Papikonda National Park, it does not have any speciality, but still it's a national park, that therefore it is important. Biosphere reserve in Andhra Pradesh. This one is the name. Seshachalam Hills, so this is the biosphere reserve and it is famous for this species, Slender Loris. Bird Sanctuary, Kolleru Bird Sanctuary is in Andhra Pradesh. Now comes Arunachal Pradesh. Remember, we are discussing Arunachal Pradesh. Now Andhra Pradesh was done. Wildlife Sanctuary, the Bagh Wildlife Sanctuary, Kamlang Wildlife Sanctuary, it is named after Kamlang River. मैं हाउ वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी कोई और पाके वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी विच इज ऑल्सो अ टाइगर रिजर्व. सो नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू अ क्वेश्चन आस्क अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम यू गाइज. हाउ मेनी टाइगर रिजर्व आर देयर इन इंडिया? टेल मी द नंबर. Good. It's 51. And the 51st tiger reserve is in which state? Tell me that as well. Absolutely right. It's Tamil Nadu. Now let's move on to this Shesa Orchid Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also an elephant reserve. Talib Valley Wildlife Sanctuary, Yodi Rabe Supse Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are in Arunachal Pradesh. Now we are discussing the national parks of Arunachal Pradesh. Namdafa National Park, which is also a UNESCO World Heritage Center, and it is specifically famous for being a tiger reserve. This is the speciality of this national park, which is in Arunachal Pradesh. Molik National Park is another national park of Arunachal Pradesh. Biosphere Reserve is Diham Dibang. It is famous for Mishmi Takin and Musk Deer. So these are the two species of fauna that is found in this biosphere. Now Assam. So Braille Wildlife Sanctuary, then we have Chakra Shila Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary. So this Chakra Shila is famous for Golden Langur, and this Dehing Patkai is famous for Elephant Sanctuary, for having elephant reserves. East Karbi Anglong Wildlife Sanctuary, Lokwa Wildlife Sanctuary, Marat Nongri, Nambod Doingrung. So these are very different and very unique names of wildlife sanctuaries that have been given to Assam in accordance with the language that Assam has. So we have the next wildlife sanctuary, that is Garampani. So whatever is the pronunciation, one of the oldest sanctuaries containing hot water spring. Therefore, the name is Garampani. This is something very funny, I find it. Okay, Kaziranga National Park. So, this is very important. One horned rhinos, this is famous. Pobitora Wildlife Sanctuary is again one horned rhinos ke liye famous. Manas National Park is UNESCO Natural World Heritage Site. Assam roofed turtle, hispid hare, and golden langur and pygmy hawk. So these are the specialities of this national park. So Manas is one of the most important national park that Assam has. Then we have Nameri National Park, which is an elephant reserve. Oren, Rajiv Gandhi Oren is the name of this national park. Then Dibru Saikova National Park. Samlan River Impenetrable National Park is being proposed. Biosphere reserves are Manas, so again Golden Langur and Red Panda, and Dibru Saikova Biosphere is famous for Golden Langur. So Golden Langur is one of the species that is found in abundance in Assam, Bihar. So Bihar mein bahut hi kam hai. Bhimband Wildlife Sanctuary, Gautam Buddha Wildlife Sanctuary. Okay, so this expands to Jharkhand as well. Kanmur Wildlife Sanctuary and Vikram Shila Gangetic Dolphin Wildlife Sanctuary. This is important. This one is important. This has the species of endangered gangetic dolphins. National Park is Valmiki National Park, Tiger Reserve and Wildlife Sanctuary. And it is the only national park in Bihar, as we can see. So Valmiki National Park is important. Next is Chhattisgarh. So again, you can see the wildlife sanctuaries. Achanak Mar and Badal Kol. So Barnabhakra and Sarangad, Gomardha, Pamed Buffalo Wildlife Sanctuary, Sita Nadi and Tamod Bingla Wildlife Sanctuary. These are the wildlife sanctuaries. Okay. And we have the national parks. Indravati National Park, famous for wild buffaloes. Okay, so I think there are many questions. Okay, so students are talking among themselves. Absolutely. National Park, Indravati National Park is famous for wild buffaloes. Kangar Valley National Park is also there. Guru Ghasi Das, Sanjay National Park is Chhattisgarh, again important. Biosphere Reserve is only one biosphere reserve, that is Achan Akmar and Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve, which expands from MP and Chhattisgarh. So this Chhattisgarh Biosphere Reserve also expands into Madhya Pradesh. So alphabetically moving, we have the next state, that is Goa. Wildlife sanctuaries are very few: Bondla, Kotigaon, Madai and Netravali are the wildlife sanctuaries. National park is Bhagwan Mahavir Molam National Park. Bird sanctuary is Chorao Island. Dr. Saleem Ali is also the name of this sanctuary, bird sanctuary. गुजरात, सो गुजरात तो इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये तो मुझे बताने की जरूरत नहीं है. तो गुजरात में जितनी भी वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज, नेशनल पार्क्स एंड बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स, व्हाटएवर इम्पोर्टेंट मॉन्यूमेंट और व्हाटएवर इम्पोर्टेंट साइट इज देयर इन गुजरात, दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ, यू शुड मेमोराइज. गुजरात वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, बलराम आमजी वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, बारदा वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, गिरनार इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. Then we have Jessore Sloth Bear Wildlife Sanctuary, Kutch Desert, largest wildlife sanctuary in India, area wise. So this is the speciality of this Kutch Desert Wildlife Sanctuary, Narayan Sarovar, Chinkara Wildlife Sanctuary, Purna Wildlife Sanctuary, Shurpaneshwar Wildlife Sanctuary, which is famous for sloth bears. So this is again important, wildlife sanctuary. Then what are the national parks in Gujarat? Black Buck National Park, Marine National Park, which is in the Gulf of Kutch. This is again an important national park. Gir Forest National Park. This too, I don't think that I need to tell you the importance of, because Gir National Park is important. It is also known as Sasan Gir. Bansala National Park, also known as Bansala National Park. Okay. Bird Sanctuary. Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, largest wetland bird sanctuary in Gujarat and one of the largest in India. So remember that it is not the largest in India, it is one of the largest in India. And largest wetland bird sanctuary in Gujarat. Biosphere Reserve, Great Run of Kutch, Indian wild dance ke liye famous. Haryana. Abub Shehar Wildlife Sanctuary, Morni Hills Wildlife Sanctuary, Bir Shikhagarh Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries. National Park is Kalisar and Sultanpur. So there is no biosphere reserve in this state. Now we are on Himachal Pradesh. Wildlife sanctuaries, Chandratal, Daran Ghati, Dholadhar, Gampul, Siyabahi, which is famous for Kashmir Stag. So this is again something important. Kashmir Stag, this one is famous. Kanwar Wildlife Sanctuary, Kibar Wildlife Sanctuary, Kukti Wildlife Sanctuary, Pong Dam Lake Wildlife Sanctuary. This was in the news, guys, Pong Dam Lake. Therefore, it is important to cover it thoroughly. Next is Rupi Bhabha Wildlife Sanctuary. Sangla Valley Wildlife Sanctuary. So, these are in Himachal Pradesh. Sech Tuam Nala Wildlife Sanctuary. This is famous for musk deer, pheasants and ibex. Kunda Wildlife Sanctuary. National parks are Pin Valley National Park, Great Himalayan National Park. So, do you remember what is the speciality of this National Park, Great Himalayan National Park. Apart from this, that it is the UNESCO World Heritage Site. Recently, Ministry of Environment has also given it the MEE score, the highest MEE score, Management Effectiveness Score, that was given by Ministry of Environment to various national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. So this was the top performer. Tell me the score of this Great Himalayan National Park. Then we have so Indrakila National Park is there, Khirganga National Park, Simbalbhaga National Park is also there, and one biosphere reserve is, that is called Desert, which is famous for snow leopards. So snow leopards is also important. Chalo guys, quickly tell me the score of this Great Himalayan National Park. What happened, guys? Don't you know the score? Okay. Rishabh has answered his, has given his answer. But what about the other people? At present, there are almost 37 people watching this session. So why are you not answering the question? Answer the question. Okay, Shilpa. So it's 84.17%. So guys, I'm not saying you to remember all the scores of all the wildlife sanctuaries, but if you're appearing for the RBI grade B examination, then you should be aware of the top wildlife sanctuary or the national park and their score as well. So the score is 84.17%. So I hope now all of you know the answer. Very good, Rishabh. It's also Tritan Wildlife Sanctuary is also there, which has topped that ranking given by Ministry of Environment. Absolutely right. And Tritan is also located in this Himachal Pradesh. Now we are on Jammu and Kashmir. Wildlife sanctuaries is Changdang Wildlife Sanctuary, Baltal Tejwas Wildlife Sanctuaries, Karakoram Nubra Shop Wildlife Sanctuaries, or it is famous for Chiru or Tibetan Antelope. That is the speciality of this wildlife sanctuary. Overa Aru Wildlife Sanctuary, Surinsar Mansar Wildlife Sanctuary, Hokersar Wildlife Sanctuary, and Trikuta Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries of Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory. National parks. Dachigam National Park, famous for Kashmiri Star. Hemis National Park or Hemis High Altitude National Park, famous for snow leopards. Kishtwar National Park is also there, and Salim Ali National Park is also in the state of, in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Next from the state, Jharkhand. So wildlife sanctuaries are Dalma Wildlife Sanctuary, Hazaribagh Wildlife Sanctuary, which is the country's only Mahodnar Wolf Sanctuary. So it is famous for this wolf. Lavalong Wildlife Sanctuaries, Palamau Wildlife Sanctuary, which is the tiger reserve, Talcott Wildlife Sanctuary. National parks are Betla National Park. So this is an important national park. Betla National Park. बर्ड सेंचुरी इज उधवा लेक बर्ड सेंचुरी. तो झारखंड इज ओवर, नाउ वी आर ऑन कर्नाटका. कावेरी वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, भद्र वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी विच इज ऑल्सो अ टाइगर रिजर्व, भीमगढ़ वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, बिली फिरी रंग स्वामी टेम्पल वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, चंदेली दरोजी स्लॉथ बियर वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. द नेम इटसेल्फ इज हाइलाइटिंग द इंपॉर्टेंस फॉर स्लॉथ बियर. मलाई महादेश्वरा वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, मुकाम्बिका वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी एंड राने गुन्नूर ब्लैक बक वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी विच इज फेमस फॉर ब्लैक बक्स. रंग्याना दुर्गा फोर हॉर्न एंटीलोप. सो दिस इज द वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी विच इज फेमस फॉर फोर हॉर्न एंटीलोप्स एंड इट इज एन इको सेंसिटिव जोन एज वेल. देन वी हैव शरावती वैली वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, शिल्टीहाली वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, सोमेश्वरा वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, येदाहली चिंकारा वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. सो दिस इज फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड सेंचुरी फॉर चिंकारा, इंडिया गजेल इन कर्नाटका. जोगीमती वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. सो वी आर ऑलमोस्ट टूवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ दिस डॉक्यूमेंट, ऑफ दिस डॉक्यूमेंट दैट इज कंटेनिंग ऑल द वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज एंड नेशनल पार्क्स. एंड गाइज दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस सेशन, सो डू लिसन टू मी पेशेंटली, डोंट लूज योर पेशेंस. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज थिमलापुरा वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, चिंचोली वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी विच इज फर्स्ट ड्राई लैंड वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज sanctuary in South India. Then we have these wildlife sanctuaries which are proposed, and the proposed wildlife sanctuaries are the most important because there are high chances that they can be asked in the examination. So do remember this thing that Kapta Guda and this Kama Sandra and Bukka Patna, all these three wildlife sanctuaries are the proposed wildlife sanctuaries of Karnataka. Let's discuss national parks. Rajiv Gandhi Nagarhol National Park, which is also a tiger reserve. Kundremukh National Park, Mandipur National Park, tiger reserve. Anshi National Park and Bannerghat National Park. So, these two are in the news very much. Biosphere Reserve, Bannerghat Biological Park is also a biosphere reserve. Next comes Kerala. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries, out of which Idukki Wildlife Sanctuary is the most important. Then we have the Muthanga, Chimni, Begur, Chinnar Wildlife Sanctuary. Chinnar is famous for great grizzled squirrel. Nayar and Parambikulam Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also the tiger reserve, which also has the tiger reserve. And that one was the UNESCO's World Heritage Site as well. Then we have these four wildlife sanctuaries in Kerala. Let's discuss the national parks. Aravikulam National Park, which is famous for Nilgiri Tar. Periyar National Park, famous for Periyar, also is a Periyar Tiger Reserve, so it is famous for tigers. Silent Valley National Park, this is an important and the very beautiful place. So if you are planning to go somewhere after your exam is ended, then you can visit this place. It's very beautiful. Lion-tailed macaques and Malabar giant squirrels. Anaimuddi National Park, Nilgiri Tar. Bird Sanctuary. Kumarakom Bird Sanctuary. Then Vembanad Bird Sanctuary. Vembanad is a lake. And it is the biggest freshwater lake in Kerala. Next is this Chulanur Peafowl Sanctuary. So the name itself is suggesting the famous species in this wildlife sanctuary is peacock. Then we have Kadalundi Bird Sanctuary. And these two are the remaining bird sanctuaries of this state. Biosphere Reserve, Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. It is one of the most important biosphere reserves in India. Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. It spans over three states. And then we have Agastya Mallai Biosphere Reserve, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Next comes the state of Madhya Pradesh. So all the states are arranged alphabetically, not geographically. Okay. Bori Wildlife Sanctuary, Gandhi Sagar Wildlife Sanctuary, Ghati Gaon Wildlife Sanctuary. This one is important for Great Indian Bustard. And Great Indian Bustards are important because for them a conservation plan is also being formulated by the Government of India. So Great Indian Bustards are in the focus. Remember that Ghati Gaon Wildlife Sanctuary is one of the sanctuaries famous for them. Okay. Noradehi Wildlife Sanctuary, potential site for cheetah reintroduction in India. So it's not very important thing to remember, just remember this thing. Tatapani Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also a tiger reserve. National Park, Kanha National Park, largest national park of Madhya Pradesh and famous for tigers. Madhav National Park, again tiger reserve. Panna National Park, Pench National Park, tiger reserve. So Madhya Pradesh is a state which is most famous for the tiger reserves, which has the most efforts towards the conservation of tigers, I would say. Then we have Sanjay National Park, Satpura National Park, which again is a tiger reserve. Then we have Bandhavgarh National Park, which is famous for Bengal tigers. Bird Sanctuary, Kalera Bird Sanctuary is there, Biosphere Reserve near Pachmarhi Biosphere Reserve is there. It is famous for giant squirrels and flying squirrels. Guys, I am again repeating this thing to remember the famous species of the wildlife sanctuaries because this is very important. Okay, Panna Vihar, it is famous for Chinkara, Sambhar and Sloth Bear. So again, we have discussed this thing. Achanakmar and Amarkantak spans from MP and Chhattisgarh. Maharashtra. Okay. Bhamragarh Wildlife Sanctuary is there, Bhimashankar is there, Chaparala is there, Dhyan Ganga is there. Great Indian Bustard Wildlife Sanctuary is also there, which is also known as Jawaharlal Nehru Bustard Sanctuary. So question can be framed from here that where is this Jawaharlal Nehru Bustard Sanctuary located? You should be aware of the answer that it is Maharashtra. Koyna Wildlife Sanctuary is there, Mani Singh Dau, Melghat Wildlife Sanctuary, which is again a tiger reserve. Pen Ganga Wildlife Sanctuary, Umred Kharandla Wildlife Sanctuary, then Diol Gaon, Rehpuri Black Buck Sanctuary, which is famous for black bucks. Malvan Marine Wildlife Sanctuary, only marine sanctuary in Maharashtra. So this is the only sanctuary of Maharashtra for marine animals. National Park, Chandoli National Park, Gugamal, Nave Gaon, Sanjay Gandhi, Borivali National Park, this is very important. Kandheri Caves within parks. So this is famous for this Kandheri Caves, which are located within the park. Tadoba Andheri National Park, state's oldest and largest national park. So this is the largest national park of Maharashtra. Bird Sanctuary, Thane Creek Flamingo Sanctuary, famous for flamingos. Next comes Manipur. So you have this, these are the sanctuaries and these are the national parks. Kebul National Park, this is the only floating national park in the world. So this is important. Kebul Lamjau National Park. Siroi National Park is famous for Tragopan. Now we have a Meghalaya, so these are the birds, the wildlife sanctuaries. You can read them on their own, on your own. The national park is Nokrek National Park, which is UNESCO's Biosphere Reserve. So this is the speciality of this park. Nokrek is the Biosphere Reserve as well, which is famous for red panda. Next comes Mizoram. These are the wildlife sanctuaries and Dampa Wildlife Sanctuary is famous for Tiger Reserve. Paul Rand Wildlife Sanctuary is famous for the Kulaw Gibbon, Sero, Wild Boar, Barking Deer and Sambha. And these are the other two wildlife sanctuaries. National Parks, Fangtooth National Park, it bears the name of mountain Fangtooth. Also called the Blue Mountains of Mizoram. So that is something that is very Good. Very unique feature of that wildlife sanctuary, national park. And what is the famous species of that national park? These are the species. These are the name of the species. So you have bits, tragopan, falcon, sunbirds, dark tongue swift, tanysis, humps, pheasant. This is the state bird of Manipur and Mizoram. Then the last national park is Murleng National Park. Now we are on Nagaland. So wildlife sanctuaries are Pulaibadzi and it is famous for bits, tragopan and dark tongue swift. Trekking wildlife sanctuary is famous for slender loris. Ranga Pahar Wildlife Sanctuary is also there in Nagaland. National Park is Itangiki National Park, which is famous for Hulog Gibbon and Golden Langur and Hornbill. Hornbill Festival. So, Hornbill Festival se bhi aap yaad rakh sakte hain. Odisha. So, these are the wildlife sanctuaries. I'm not going to read them out on your own because you will be provided with the PDF of this document. Already this PDF has been provided in the Infinity portal where all the details PDF of the static topics that I have taken here are provided for the students. Okay, so this is the national park, Simlipal National Park, which is also a tiger reserve, Bhitarkanika National Park, saltwater crocodile and Indian python clear. This one is famous, and Nandankanan Zoological Park is also there. Simlipal Biosphere Reserve is also there and it is famous for Royal Bengal Tigers and it is a part of UNESCO's World Network of Biosphere Reserves. So this is important. Next comes Punjab. Only two wildlife sanctuaries are there in Punjab, Abohar and Birbhsawan Wildlife Sanctuary. Rajasthan, Mount Abu Wildlife Sanctuary, famous for Indian leopards. Sariska Tiger Reserve, Kalidevi Wildlife Sanctuary and this Kumbhalgarh Wildlife Sanctuary, famous for Asiatic lions. So Asiatic lions is one of the most important or rare species that India has, and the wildlife sanctuaries that have these lions are important. So this one is important. Phulbari Ki Nar Wildlife Sanctuary, Sita Mata Wildlife Sanctuary, then we have Todgarh Rowley Wildlife Sanctuary. These are the wildlife sanctuaries in Rajasthan. Out of these, this one is famous. Ranthambore National Park, Sawai Madhopur Game Sanctuary is also the name of this Ranthambore National Park, famous for tiger reserves. Desert Wala is famous for Great Indian Bustard. Mukundra Hills National Park is also in Rajasthan. Bird sanctuaries, Kyoladio National Park, इससे पहले it was named as Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. So this one is also important. This is a World Heritage Site. Sikkim, wildlife sanctuaries are only these two. National Park is this one, which is also a World Heritage Site. So Biosphere Reserve is also the same. Snow leopard and red panda are the famous species. Tamil Nadu. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries, and no speciality of these sanctuaries are mentioned here. Therefore, it is easier for you to remember these sanctuaries. National parks are Mukurthi National Park, Muthumalai National Park, Indira Gandhi Annamalai National Park, Gulf of Mannar Marine National Park. All these four are important national parks. Bird sanctuary. So you have this Kanjirangkulam Bird Sanctuary, Vedanthangalam Thangal Bird Sanctuary. It is the oldest water bird sanctuary in the country. So it is important. It talks about the national level. So oldest bird sanctuary at the national level is Vedanthangal Bird Sanctuary. Palikat Lake Bird Sanctuary is also in the news. It is important. So these two are very important for you to remember. It is the second largest brackish water ecosystem in India, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So it spans from Tamil Nadu to Andhra Pradesh. Biosphere Reserve, Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, three states mein it expands. Agasthyamalai Biosphere Reserve, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Then we have Gulf of Mannar, Dugong or Sea Cow. Are these species that are found in this Gulf of Mannar and they are very famous. Annamalai is famous for being a tiger reserve. Telangana. These are the wildlife sanctuaries out of which Kavag Wildlife Sanctuary is tiger reserve. It's famous for tigers. Mahavir Harina Vanasthali National Park, Deer National Park and Blackbuck's Deer Kile, this one is famous. And Blackbuck is also the state animal of Andhra Pradesh. So this is important. So this is Kasu Brahmanada, Brahmanand Reddy National Park, Peacock's Kile famous. And this one is another national park, Tripura. Wildlife sanctuaries are these much, and out of these, Trishna Wildlife Sanctuary is famous for Indian God. Then you have the national parks, Clouded Leopard National Park and Bison National Park. At the end, we have Uttarakhand, Ashok Musk Deer Wildlife Sanctuary. We have Nandor Wildlife Sanctuary, which is famous for tigers. Kedarnath Wildlife Sanctuary is famous for musk deer. Sona Nadi Wildlife Sanctuary is also there. National Parks, Gangotri National Parks, Snow Leopard and Ka, Govind Pashu Vihar is also there. Jim Corbett for very famous sites for tigers. Nanda Devi National Park is World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Rajaji National Park for elephants. Valley of Flowers National Park is also there. Nanda Devi National Park and Biosphere Reserve, again a part of UNESCO World Network of Biosphere Reserves. Uttar Pradesh. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries of Uttar Pradesh. Hastinapur hai, Chandrapur Prabha, Ketavni Ghat and National Chambal Wildlife Sanctuary. This is famous for critically endangered gharials. Pilbit is also very much in the news. This one is also very much in the news. Pilbit Wildlife Sanctuary. Tiger reserves. It recently got an award for doubling the population of tigers. Tell me the name of the award that it got. Soman, if you are asking me that only wildlife sanctuaries and national parks will do for your static GK, then my answer would be no. Only remembering wildlife sanctuaries and national parks will not suffice your preparation for static GK. All the topics that I have taken today and in the last session are important for you to cover your static GK. But yes, the national parks and wildlife sanctuaries mentioned in the PDF, all the wildlife sanctuaries and national parks are important for you to remember. But still, if you have not remembered all of them till now, then I understand that the time is very short and you cannot memorize all the wildlife sanctuaries. Therefore, pay attention to the one that are famous, that have some speciality, that have some description right on the right hand side of them, so that you cannot lost track of the important wildlife sanctuaries and national parks which are there, and also the one that I'm mentioning in the session right here. Absolutely right, guys. It's T into 2 award, which is given for doubling the population of tigers. Good. Next is Ranipur Wildlife Sanctuary, Mahavir Swami Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries. National park is Dudhwa National Park, and we have only one national park in Uttar Pradesh. It is Tiger Reserve is also there in this national park, Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary and Katarnya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary form Dudhwa National Park. So these are the two reserves or wildlife sanctuaries to portions that form the Dudhwa National Park. Bird Sanctuary, Bhimrao Ambedkar Bird Sanctuaries, and Nagabhanj Bird Sanctuary, which was earlier known as Shaheed Chandrasekhar Azad Bird Sanctuary. Okay, so these are the two other bird sanctuaries. West Bengal. Lothian Island Wildlife Sanctuary. So it is famous for these animals. Sajnakhali Wildlife Sanctuary, West Sundarban Wildlife Sanctuary, or Jor Khopri Wildlife Sanctuary. This is famous for Himalayan salamander. National parks. Baksar National Park, Gorumura National Park. All these national parks have some or the other speciality mentioned here. Baksar is famous for tiger reserves. Gorumura is for one-horned rhinos. Noida is for red pandas. And then we have Jaldapara for one-horned Indian rhinos. Sundarban National Park is UNESCO World Heritage Site. So, what do we decipher from here? That national parks in Uttar Pradesh are very important because they have some or the other importance attached to them. Next is Sundarban Biosphere Reserve. Royal Bengal Tiger is the famous one. Next, Andaman and Nicobar Island. So it has Barren Island Wildlife Sanctuary, dominated by barren volcano. So it is the only confirmed active volcano in South Asia. Chinook Islands Wildlife Sanctuary, part of Mahatma Gandhi Marine Wildlife Sanctuary. And these two are other wildlife sanctuaries. National Park of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Campbell Bay National Park. This remains in the news very much. It's important. South Button Island National Park, Cedar Peak National Park. These are the animals for which this national park is famous for. Mount Harriet National Park and Mahatma Gandhi Marine Bandur National Park. And these are some of the other national parks of Andaman and Nicobar. And the Biosphere Reserve is Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve, which is the only Biosphere Reserve in Andaman and Nicobar. Saltwater crocodile is the species for which this Biosphere Reserve is famous for. Delhi, Asola Bharti Indra Priyadarshini Wildlife Sanctuary. These are the Chandigarh Wildlife Sanctuary, Sukhna Wildlife Sanctuary. Then we have Bird Sanctuary in Chandigarh, City Bird Sanctuary, and Parrot Bird Sanctuary. Lakshadweep Bird Sanctuary is this, Pitti Bird Sanctuary. Puducherry only has one bird sanctuary, so these are the Union Territories. Osudu Bird Sanctuary and Daman and Diu Bird Sanctuary is Pudam Bird Sanctuary. So guys, this is the map which has been given for you to remember the Biosphere Reserves better. So this is the map of Biosphere Reserve, and here the session ends. I hope that you have liked this session, and this session helps you in covering your static GK better. If you have any queries related to what I have taught in this session or anything related to the examination, then you can connect with me on the Telegram channel, which is provided, the link of which is provided in the description below. Also guys, do not worry about the link of the PDF. I will be giving you the PDF link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching the video.